It's time now for Police on the Scene with a Crime Prevention Lean, with your host, police officer and national crime prevention professional, J.D. Dine.
Hi, Tim Kretschmann with PoliceOnTheScene.com, and I'm speaking to
Elliott Schneider.
Hi, Elliott. You're here, and you have a very interesting display over here. Does he do tricks?
He does, most certainly. Actually, as you can see here, some of the people that are coming up here get to experience a diver in the water. And they can throw little things into the water, and the diver will come in and pick up the dive sticks and throw them back out to the kids. What we're using right now is a underwater communication device, and people on land can actually communicate with the diver below water.
So a lot has changed since, who was it, Jacques Cousteau created
yes.
scuba, right?
Correct.
I remember something. Scuba is self-contained underwater breathing apparatus,
that's
right?
Correct.
Huh? Watching Jaws 58 times, I learned something. That's good. Now, do these guys have to encounter sharks, or what's the most
no.
dangerous thing?
No stingrays.
Lake Michigan,
sharks.
There's no sharks.
No.
Absolutely?
No. Absolutely.
So I'm safe.
You're 100%
okay,
safe.
Okay, fantastic. This is a great concern to me. But what are they finding underwater?
As far as I know, on Lake Michigan, just your typical fish, bass, okay. sea bass and stuff.
But when they're deployed, they're out to find something.
Right.
Rescuing people? Or
in the event that the dive team gets called out, it's usually for either a recovery or a boater that's distressed. And we usually go out and, you know, get that.
Okay.
Pick them out of the water.
Now, this water's pretty clean. What does he do when he's out? I'm sure Lake Michigan, it's a little less visibility
right.
than what we're seeing right here.
Actually, Lake Michigan and the Milwaukee River are very murky, so we rely on a buddy system. So we use a lot of ropes, and on shore, we're tied up to the shore so that our firemen on the shore can kind of direct us, and we have signals that we use in the event that there's a problem. So say there's an issue on down below, we could tug on the line 3 times, and that means come out.
That means come out.
Yeah,
well, that's,
that means get me out
that's
here.
Good to know. That's good to know. Now, the technology's come a long way over the years.
Most certainly.
What's the coolest new toy you guys have for underwater? I watched James Bond, too, so you won't be able to snow me on this
I
stuff.
I think the newest thing would probably be...
Okay. He's bringing back a prop, ladies and gentlemen.
Is our line gun.
That's a line gun?
A line gun. It uses...
Why would you shoot a lion under the water? No, no, that's
not
rope.
Not that line.
He means rope. Okay. I'm sorry.
A rope gun.
A rope gun. Okay, so that shoots rope.
It'll shoot across a river
okay.
or anything that's unattained that we can't get access to. So
okay.
this, we can deploy, I believe it's about... 600 feet of line.
600 feet of line. That's a good shot if you can hit what you're shooting
be a good
at
shot.
That. Yeah, and the wind would probably take
yeah.
a rope and do horrible things with it.
But I think this tool, I think, is probably the best that we've seen in the last few years that has come out for as far as technology.
Now, all this stuff is very expensive, and we ask all of our viewers, help out your local fire and police departments. Help donate some of this great technology that they're saving people's lives with.
Yes, I agree. You know, days like this, Bayshore Safety Day, this is a perfect example for kids and families to come down here and enjoy a great day to see all these different departments in action and see what they do. And, you know, like you said, nowadays with the economy and stuff, I know budgets are tight and stuff, so any bit of money from the community and your support helps.
Okay, now I see one of these masks, so I want to have you grab one of these masks here. And this looks a little different from my sleep apnea mask here.
This looks like a Star Wars mask, doesn't it?
It does. Luke, I'm your father. So what is the advantage to this over the thing that I used to see in Sea Hunt with Lloyd Bridges?
The advantage to this is it has our communication device on it.
Okay.
And it also allows us, you push a button on the left-hand side as you're underwater, and you can communicate, like I said, using that device there.
Okay, or you could just stick your head out of the top and talk. All this high tech, I don't understand. Okay.
But this feature has been out for probably about 5-6 years now, And it's so far it's done pretty well for us.
Well, that's got to be a big game changer when your signal before I hear was tugging three times on a rope.
Right.
So that's got to be very important when the things get right. difficult on
and
your
not
ladder.
To mention, we can also talk with the other divers. So there's that intercommunication between the divers underwater. So there's no, like, where are you type of thing or, you know, what's going on.
Everybody Look out, knows. Shark. Yeah. These are all important.
Yeah, boat's coming.
Duck. Yeah, okay. Actually, duck, like, duck down, not because those aren't too scary. But they do quack up. Okay, well, thank you very much, Elliott.
Well, thank you so much for your time.
We appreciate it.
Thank you.
Please visit TKPN at our website, www.tkpnpodcast.com.
You've been listening to a TKPN production.